Blessed are those who with noble and generous hearts take the word of God to themselves and yield a harvest through their perseverance. Let's sing together. Alleluia. Let's clap.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Remember to keep your hands open as a sign of our openness to what Jesus has to say to us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Herod the Tetrarch heard about the reputation of Jesus, and he said to his court, "This is John the Baptist himself. He has risen from the dead. And that is why miraculous powers are at work in him." Now it was Herod who had arrested John, chained him up, and put him in prison because of Herodias, his brother Philip's wife. For John had told him, "It is against the law for you to have her." He had wanted to kill him, but was afraid of the people who regarded John as a prophet. Then, during the celebration for Herod's birthday, the daughter of Herodias danced before the company and so delighted Herod that he promised on oath to give her anything she asked. Prompted by her mother, she said, "Give me John the Baptist's head here on a dish." The king was distressed, but thinking about the oaths he had sworn and about his guests, he ordered it to be given her and sent and had John beheaded in the prison. The head was brought in on a dish and given to the girl, who took it to her mother. John's disciples came and took the body and buried it. And they went off to tell Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now children, please open your Bibles to Matthew chapter 14. We are in verses 1 to 12. Matthew chapter 14. Please open your Bibles, everyone. Parents, please assist the children in opening the Bible, and this is a good habit that we can form. My dear children, I want to tell you that today I am very nervous, because today's gospel is, you know, like how you have at home when you watch TV, there are movies for big people and movies for children, and mommy and daddy tell you, you can't watch the movies for big people, right? Or when you're watching, they'll tell you, close your eyes, cover your face. Today's gospel, children, is like a gospel for big people. Huh? They're all big people problems. There is murder, and there is hatred, and there is vengeance, and there is adultery. And you'll ask me, what tree is this? What kind of tree is adultery? That we'll tell you later, okay? So how am I going to teach you this? I thought for a while and I said, first let me share with you something that you will understand. And from there, I will explain to you what happened in today's gospel. So I want to share with you children about a saint that I like very much. He's one of my favorite saints. I've got many saints who I like very much. Saint Martha is one of my other favorite saints. But this is a modern saint. His name is Oscar Romero. Oscar Romero, children, was a bishop. He lived in South America in the country of San Salvador. And Oscar Romero died or was killed 40 years ago on the 24th of March, 1980. You know how I remember that date so well, 24th of March, because I was born on the 24th of March, 10 years before. On my 10th birthday, Bishop Oscar Romero gave his life. He was killed. I want to tell you about his life, children, so that you understand how in the church, many good people have given up their life for what is good and what is true. Yes? So let me tell you about the life of this bishop. He was a simple priest. And then one fine day, the Vatican decided to make him bishop of this diocese. Now children, what was happening in San Salvador when he became bishop? It was very difficult. The country was going through a very difficult time. Who was in charge? The people who were in charge, children, San Salvador is really a Catholic country. These were all Catholics, and mostly Catholics. And the people in charge were also Catholics. The army had taken over the country. Okay? It was like controlled by the army. And children, they were terrible people. They used to go out, pull people from their home, shoot them in front of their families, throw them in prison, torture hundreds and thousands of people. And they didn't do this only to people. They did this even to the priests and the nuns. They wanted to put everybody down so that they were in charge. They wanted to frighten the whole country. And Bishop Oscar Romero, children, felt he needed to say something. His own priests were being killed. He used to always be a quiet bishop, always quietly praying for everybody. But one day, he could not take it anymore. His best friend, who was a priest, who was going to baptize some children in another village, was pulled out of his car and shot. And Bishop Oscar Romero felt now he needed to do something. From that day onwards, he left the place where he was staying and he would be with the people. He would talk against injustice. He would not say we have to do wrong. He would not say if they are beating us, we have to beat them. No. He would talk about justice, about standing up for the truth, of fighting evil. He would talk about all of this. And the government, the army did not like it, children. They were getting angry every day. They were getting angry. You know what they did one day? When Bishop Oscar Romero went to meet some people in a small town to insult him, they came to him and they tore off all his clothes. Tore it. You know what the people did? They took off their clothes and they covered him. Because they realized that Bishop Oscar Romero loved the people. He stood up. He fought for what is right. He spoke the truth. Whereas these people in the army were evil people. And so the army warned Bishop Oscar Romero. They said, if you don't keep quiet, we will kill you. He never kept quiet, children. He continued to speak loudly. And then one day, when he was celebrating Mass like this, on the 24th of March in 1980, the army sent some people inside, and while he was saying the Mass, they shot him. He died at this altar, giving praise and thanks to Jesus. You know, children, you might think that Bishop Oscar Romero, he struggled a lot. But he didn't only have problems with the army and these terrible people. He even had problems within the church. St. John Paul II at that time was the Pope. And St. John Paul was very worried about what was happening in that country. We know today that St. John Paul II called Bishop Oscar Romero to the Vatican and he shouted at him. He said, I want you to stop all of this. Today I wonder what these two saints are discussing in heaven. Yeah, Bishop Romero went back. But he did what was true. He did what he had to do. And for that, children, he paid a price. Now let me come to today's gospel, children. Today we hear of another person who spoke the truth. Who was that? John the Baptist. John the Baptist was sent to be a witness, children. See, what is a witness? Supposing, children, outside this church, there is a car accident and I'm standing down. Two cars come and bang. I am standing there and I have seen it. Okay? So I have witnessed that. I have witnessed the accident. I can't say I have witnessed it, no? If Brother Paolo comes up and says, Arey, Father Warner, you know what happened outside? Two cars came and bang. I can't say I'm a witness. I can only say I'm a witness when I have seen it myself. So John the Baptist was a witness. He had met Jesus. He had experienced Jesus. Correct? Now, A witness has to do the second part also. Having seen it, I must be ready to talk and tell the truth about it. No? Supposing tomorrow, those two cars that banged, the police caught them, took them to the court, and the judge said, has anybody seen that accident? Father Warner will have to say, yes, judge. I saw that accident. I was there. I saw whose fault it was. I saw how he came fast and this man just overtook and they banged. I have to give my testimony. But I can only give my testimony, children, if I have seen it firsthand, I have experienced it firsthand. And second, that I am willing to tell the truth. Yeah? Now, supposing one of them is my friend, I should not go and say, he's my friend, so if I tell the truth in the court, my friend will go to jail. So I tell the judge, no judge, you know, I was there, but I didn't see properly. That day, I didn't have my glasses. I couldn't see. That is telling a lie, children. Huh? That is telling a lie. So what does John the Baptist do? He has seen Jesus. He has experienced Jesus. Now he does the second thing. He bears witness. He says, look, this is the Lamb of God. But he also, children, bore witness to the truth. Yes, like in that accident, you see something, you have to tell the truth. When you see something wrong happening, you have to tell the truth. You can't tell a lie. John the Baptist told the truth. What truth did he tell? You know, children, at that time, when John the Baptist lived, there was a king. His name was Herod Antipas. He was a very strange king. Yeah, when you become bigger, I'll tell you about him a little more. But he's a little strange fellow. He had a wife, children. He left that wife and he went to Rome. There he met his brother. He went to see his brother in Rome. And there he falls in love with his brother's wife and he brings her back. Not allowed or not allowed? Not allowed, huh? Not allowed, huh? Daddy has to stay with mommy, huh? Okay? So, this fellow left his wife and he's gone and brought another one. Okay? And he's staying with them. Now, what does John the Baptist do? He says, hello, you can't do this. This is wrong. This is wrong. Now, everybody is following John the Baptist, no? So if John the Baptist said it is wrong, then what does everybody say? It is wrong. They should have said. They didn't say. They were all frightened of the king. So the only one who stood up and said, what you are doing, King Herod, is wrong, was John the Baptist. What did Herod do? Herod got angry. He said, I'm in charge. So he took John the Baptist and put him in a dungeon, put him in chains, locked him up. Children, I've seen that dungeon. It's in Jordan. I went there. It was a palace of called Macarius, and I prayed there at the place where John the Baptist was killed. So he put him in that dungeon. And then what happened? One day his daughter was dancing. It's not his daughter, but that lady that he brought, his brother's wife that he brought home. She had a daughter, and on Herod's birthday, this girl was dancing, and Herod was saying, wah, wah, superb. Ask me whatever you want. So well you dance, I'll give you anything. What did she do? She went to her mummy and said, mummy, King Herod is saying, what should I, he's asking me, what do I want? What should I ask? She could have said, give me one nice big palace. Give me lots of people to help me. Give me beautiful dresses. She could have asked. What does she do? She goes to her mummy. Her mummy still hates John the Baptist. So what did the mummy say? I want John the Baptist's head. Ask for his head. Cut off his head. Now look at Herod. Herod, King Herod, could have again spoken the truth and said, no, I punished him. It's not his fault. But now to take his life is a sin. Yes, King Herod could have said that. No, I did one wrong thing. You're asking me to do another wrong thing? He could have said no. But what did Herod do? He was frightened. He was worried about his image. What will people say? So what he did? He did another wrong thing. And he had John the Baptist killed. Now, my dear children, I want to say this to you. Listening to this, you will also say, Father Warner, I'm going to tell the truth from today onwards. I am always going to be honest. I don't want to be like this terrible king. I want to be like John the Baptist. I want to tell the truth. Very good, children. But I want to warn you. See, telling the truth doesn't always mean that you're going to get one nice peda and one ice cream. Huh? People don't like when you tell the truth, children. Huh? They don't like. supposing in school, yeah, your two friends are, one friend is fighting with somebody you don't like, huh? One is your friend, one is not your friend. They are fighting. Okay? Your friend started the fight. And teacher said, tell me who started the fight. You know, no, children. If you say, teacher, my friend started the fight, then will your friend talk to you the next day? He won't talk to you, no? He'll say, why did you take my name? I don't want to talk to you tomorrow. So sometimes when we tell the truth, people don't like the truth. But, and listen to this, children, Jesus still wants us to be honest. Yes, we've learned, no? Honesty is the best policy. You may not always get good results. You may all not always get one shabash. Sometimes people are even angry because we are honest. Yeah? But we have to follow Jesus, children. We have to learn to follow Jesus. And Jesus then helps us to grow more like Him. So children, today ask Jesus for this help. Say, Lord, say, Jesus, I love you. Like John the Baptist who loved you. He was your cousin. He loved you so much. He always told the truth. Even I want to tell the truth, Jesus. Sometimes it is difficult. Yeah? Whenever you feel, no, children, that I want to tell the truth and you're worried, you're not sure, what should I do? What should you do, children, when you're worried and you're not sure? Go to Jesus. Just close your eyes. Yeah? Just close your eyes. If you've got one small altar in your house, quietly go and sit down and look at the altar and say, Jesus, I don't know what to do. I want to do the correct thing, but I'm frightened. Help me, Jesus. And children, Jesus helps us. He always helps us. Look, today at the end of the gospel we heard, when they cut off John the Baptist's head, his disciples took his body and they buried it. And then where did the disciples go? They went to Jesus. They also were worried. They were also sad. Whenever we are sad, when we are worried, when we don't know whether we should do the right thing or not, where should we go? Always go to Jesus, children. He is your best friend. He's your best friend. Go to Jesus and tell Him, Jesus, I don't know what to do. I love you so much, but I'm frightened. If I tell the truth, I might get punished for being honest. But help me, Jesus. And Jesus will always help you, children. Now close your eyes for 2 minutes and say, Jesus, help me to be honest, truthful. Help me to stand up for what is right. And help me not to do things that are wrong. Keep your eyes closed, children.